Let me first ask you about the effect that this documentary and what I described as a fringe movement, which I think you called it anyway, in the film, actually is having some impact right now.
Well, I definitely think the Free Britney movement is shining a spotlight on the conservatorship system right now. You know, there was a recent court hearing last week, and I think some of the headlines are overblowing what happened. The judge actually just affirmed a decision that was already made in November to have her father, Jamie Spears, and this new trust, Bessemer Trust, to co-conserve her finances, but it wasn't, you know, her father is still in charge, and it shows how slowly everything moves through the court system, that it's 3 months later and the exact same thing is being reaffirmed. So I'm not sure how much different it is, you know.
Okay, well, it's been 12 years, and she's 39 years old, and she's got apparently something like a $60 million fortune. Can you, I'm going to play a soundbite from the film. It's one of your colleagues who's talking about the conservatorship, and then we can talk about what it actually is.
Spears, can you tell us what's going on? How's Britney doing?
Around this time, Jamie, Britney's father, files for a temporary conservatorship over Britney.
We hope the best for your daughter, sir.
Conservatorships are a unique legal arrangement, usually designed for elderly people who are unable to take care of themselves or their money. The court gives someone else special powers to make decisions for them. It's unusual because Britney is so young and productive. But there's speculation that she may be dealing with mental illness issues or drug abuse issues, or otherwise would benefit from this layer of protection. And it's sort of surprising in that Jamie wasn't a huge figure in her life before this.
Get out. All right, everybody out.
So, Samantha, I think what's shocked everybody is that this legal implement is being used against a young and successful woman who's clearly productive. We think of it as being used for those who are, you know, outside their normal ability to operate. Also, you know, it looks like we don't exactly know the legal rationale for why the judge keeps doubling down on it. Could you figure that out in the course of the documentary?
You know, it's really difficult because so many of the court records are sealed. A lot of them also include medical records, which are always sealed. The central mystery of our film really is, how could somebody make millions of dollars performing in Vegas, headlining her own show, you know, appearing on The X Factor and making albums, and also qualify for this layer of protection, which is usually meant for people who are incapable of making decisions in their own best interest. So it's very mysterious, and we don't know what the legal reasoning is behind it because all the records are sealed.
So there's another clip from a lawyer, Adam Streisand, who Britney Spears tried to employ to represent her. And I want to play this clip because then he wasn't able to.
I've got a medical report, and you haven't seen it, Mr. Streisand, and I'm not going to show it to you. And it shows that she's not capable of retaining counsel and directing counsel on her own. When the judge told me, Mr. Streisand, I'm not going to let you represent her, I'm going to appoint somebody, I felt that was not the right decision by the judge. I felt that based on my interactions with Britney, that she was capable of retaining me and directing me, and that the judge should have allowed that to happen.
And I guess you must have asked, or your colleagues, how usual is it for a judge to deny one of the parties to employ, hire their own lawyer to represent them?
You know, we did ask that a lot, and it happens fairly often in this conservatorship system. It's called guardianship in other states outside of California. So basically, you know, say your mother has Alzheimer's, that's mostly who this is meant for, and kind of a lawyer who's not very good but wants her money tries to represent her. So then the judge could say, you know, no, she's not capable of choosing a lawyer. Let's choose her one of our in our circle that will come and represent her as a court-appointed attorney. And so, you know, Britney, a medical record, a medical, you know, exam, we think was done with her while she was in the hospital on under 5150 medical health hold. And whatever that said she was incapable of hiring her own lawyer. Now, Adam Streisand met with her and says he does not think that's true. It does seem pretty subjective. And the lawyers, you know, they're not public defenders. They're these lawyers that will get paid as much as a lawyer she would hire herself would be. And Adam Streisand is a reputable lawyer. So it's very, you know, it seems like a big conflict of interest there, that her father, who was applying to be her conservator, could choose a doctor to go and analyze her.
Which the lawyer never got to see, and the judge hasn't shared. And the judge, as we've noted, has appointed a court-appointed lawyer for Britney Spears. Now, it has to be said that Britney's dad, Jamie Spears, who is the guardian under this thing, he has said, and just last month, or actually in December, when a family member needs special care and protection, families need to step up, as I have done for the last 12 plus years, to safeguard, protect, and continue to love Britney unconditionally. I have and will continue to provide unwavering love and fierce protection against those with self-serving interests and those who seek to harm her or my family. Tell me a little bit more about what you about the story of the father, because we hear throughout the film that he wasn't always there. He wasn't that close to her. Her mother was closer to her. Her mother seems to have been, you know, the person who helped, you know, move her career along and supported from the beginning. And we also see that she has started to ask for her father not to be in this position. What could you figure out the dynamic between the father and Britney? And also, where's the mother on the scene right now? Lynn Spears.
Right. So it's very confusing to us, because what we do know about Jamie is that when Britney was growing up, he struggled with alcoholism. We know he went to rehab. We know he had trouble managing money and filed for bankruptcy, he and Lynn together. And you really don't see that much of him in Britney's life until this conservatorship happened. And, you know, people a lot of the times are asking me, why was Jamie chosen over Lynn, Britney's mother? Britney's mother, as far as we know, didn't apply to be a conservator. So Jamie was chosen. We also know that there were other people involved with this. It's not her father by himself. There's lawyers, there's business managers, there's other people. So it's really unclear how he became the person, you know, the face of this, the person he was in charge of her personal life, meaning, you know, her medical care, like making decisions about her medical care, who comes to visit her, you know, if she can have security 24 hours a day. And that recently he stepped down from that, and now she has a temporary conservator in charge of her person. But he is still right in charge of her estate, which means, you know, Britney can't sign checks. She can't enter into business deals herself. Every single thing she buys has to be listed and monitored by the court. So we saw these court records that showed, you know, $5.75 at Target, $15 at Starbucks, every single thing she spends. And this is someone making millions of dollars. So, you know, Lynn Spears recently, she has to file as an interested party because she's not technically part of the conservatorship. But recently she has hired lawyers and had them come to court. And she also feels like her ex-husband should step down.